Iron Gwazi, Busch Gardens Tampa's newest roller coaster, is widely considered the best roller coaster in the world. The hype for this ride was endless, and I finally decided to arrange another trip to Florida. After years of waiting, the ride was more than worth it. But did this record-breaking hybrid coaster surpass my expectations? Find out in this video if Iron Gwazi is my new number one, or if it fell short to Steel Vengeance. Iron Gwazi was the main reason I got out to the park. With the ride opening, it gave me an excuse to come back to the park. I had been meaning to return since Cheetah Hunt had been closed on my last visit, but with these two rides finally open, I made it a priority to visit Busch Gardens. The second I got through the front gate, I ran to Iron Gwazi. I asked for the front row on my first ride. A lot of people told me that the ride would run slow in the morning, so my expectations were toned down to accommodate. I thought the ride was solid on my first ride. The pacing really showed in the front row, but the airtime wasn't hitting like I thought it would. In the afternoon, I came back after riding Cheetah Hunt and sneaking a ride in on Kumba. This time, I took the backseat and the ride was so much better. It surpassed my high expectations. The difference from the front in the morning to back in the afternoon is day and night. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get night rides because the park closed early, but the rides I got were still flawless. From my rides, what stood out to me in terms of the ride's elements include the first drop. Towering over the park with 206 feet at a 91-degree angle drop, I assumed the drop would be good, and my expectations were easily met. I haven't ridden an RMC with a bad drop yet. All the rides crank it to 11 the second they detach from the lift hill. And it all starts with an amazing first drop. I doubted the drop when I first saw it testing in the morning because of how much the ride slows down at the top. Yet I was still blown away by the power in the back row. No RMC comes close to the sheer power of this drop. I don't know what makes the first drop so good. The height, the steepness, the speed, or even the profiling. But this ride had the best first drop out of any of the RMCs I have experienced. And that was just the beginning of the insane ride. From there, you rocket up an Outer Banked Airtime Hill. In my honest opinion, I prefer this one to Steel Vengeance's. There is no doubting that the whip entering and exiting this airtime hill is much more rapid and powerful. And even at the apex, the airtime is pretty powerful. Front or back, you're going to be launched out of your seat. This was a top element on the ride, and it only sets up for the famous death roll. This lives up to every ounce of hype it got. This element is taken faster than it feels like it should, and the whip while coming down is unparalleled to any inversion. I expected it to feel like Velocicoaster's Mosasaurus roll, but it was completely different. Both are the best inversions I have ever experienced. The sheer power of the death roll cannot be expressed. I'd recommend the ride for this element alone. It highlights the ride and elevates it to elite RMC status. But what really sold the ride for me was that wave turn above the station. This is another element taken at an insane pace. You are ejected and whipped simultaneously. It's powerful ejector air, and many would consider it the best moment of air on the ride, and I would completely agree. This became my favorite moment of lateral ejector air time. I'd consider it the best element on the ride regardless of the flawless previous elements. The ride after that doesn't have anything as standout as the previous elements, but every element still hits and packs power. I don't think there really is a dull spot anywhere in the entire layout. I found every hill to deliver, and the ride was very well paced. The only complaint I could see is its shorter length compared to Steel Vengeance, but because of how impactful each element is, I wouldn't want it longer. I really do think it's the perfect RMC. Everything from the airtime, to the inversions, to the pacing was executed to perfection. This is what makes me rank it ahead of Steel Vengeance. I do believe this is Rocky Mountain Construction's best work. They managed to outdo themselves with this phenomenal addition. Tell me in the comments if you have ridden Iron Gwazi and where it ranks for you. Thank you so much for watching.